La ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah. La ilaha illallah, jud alayna, ha Allah. La ilaha illallah, jud alayna.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations, peace, and blessings upon the best of creation, the jewel and crown of creation, the beloved of Allah Almighty, the coolness to our eyes, the purpose of our lives, the reviver of our hearts, the inspirer to our minds, the awakener of our souls, the most honored one, the most praised one, the most generous one, the most kind one, undoubtedly the most beautiful one. None other than Sayyiduna Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa barik wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Al-Quran Al-Kareem, in many a place, has spoke about insan. The word insan in the Arabic language is, or its roots are nisyan, nasiya yansa. Nisyan in the Arabic language simply means to forget. And if we look at the linguistic aspect of this word, then no doubt man who is referred to as insan, his nature, the nature of man, within his DNA, within the construction of the human being, we have this automatic concept of forgetfulness. Insan, human, the human race generally tend to forget. And this is the reality. And many a time we've seen this. A prime example is now, for example, we will listen to the talk today. By next Friday, we would have forgotten. Rather, never mind, next Friday, by tomorrow, we will have forgotten what has been said here in Al-Quran Al-Kareem. But this is human nature. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Al-Quran Al-Kareem told us that when Sayyidina Adam was told not to eat from the tree, فَنَسِيَ. Allah Almighty said that Sayyidina Adam forgot. He forgot, and hence why, for that reason, Sayyidina Adam ate from the tree. He had a lapse of concentration, a moment of forgetfulness. And we as humans are descendants of Sayyidina Adam. And insan in his nature is to forget. Hence why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Al-Quran Al-Kareem has also said, فَذَكِّرْ وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind them. Give reminders to them. Always remind them. Why? For indeed, the believers are always constantly in need of reminder. The believers are always need, they always need to be reminded. Because we forget. That's why Allah Almighty is telling us to remind. Because of our nature. How many janazas have we visited and been to? How many funerals have we read and performed? And how many times have we in that moment thought of death, maut? And then within moments, after a day or two or three, we're back to our busy lifestyles. We're back to working, we're back to our families, back to our children, back to our mobile phones, for example, social media, all of this, because of this, we then tend to forget the reminder. We tend to forget the harsh reality of this world. And the reason for that is because we are humans. It's in our nature. We are insan. Insan, the word insan is derived from the word nisyan. Nisyan means to forget. Allah Almighty has an entire chapter in the Quran called Suratul Insan. There's an entire chapter of the Quran named the chapter of the human, mankind. And Allah Almighty begins this chapter, He begins this with the verse, هَلْ أَتَىٰ عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٌ مَذْكُورًا. Was there not a moment upon time? Was there not a time, a moment upon man? لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. Allah Almighty said that he was not anything to even be mentioned. What does this mean? This here, Allah Almighty is warning us. Allah Almighty is reminding us. Allah Jalla wa'ala is telling us the stark reality that, O man, there was a time when nobody knew you. You was not in existence. You was ma'doom. And from Adam, we brought you into wujud, into existence. You was nothing. And Allah Almighty is reminding, هَلْ أَتَىٰ عَلَىٰ الْإِنسَانِ. هَلْ, this is more particle istifhamiya, questioning. You know, have you forgotten? Was there not? It's like a rhetorical question Allah is asking me and you. A rhetorical question Allah Almighty is asking me and you. Do you remember? Do you not? Have you forgotten that there was a time upon me and you when we was nothing? There was no existence of man. Man came into existence after. هَلْ أَتَىٰ عَلَىٰ الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٌ مَذْكُورًا. When there was no man, no insan, there was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the dhat of Allah Jalla wa'ala, Allah Almighty Himself, He is wajibul wujud. Understand this term. Allah Almighty is wajibul wujud. The existence of Allah Almighty is necessary. The existence of Allah Almighty is wajib. He exists, everything exists. And His zat, His sifat, they all exist. And they have no beginning, they have no end. Allah Almighty is awwalun bila ibtida, wa akhirun bila intiha. Allah Almighty is the first without a beginning. And Allah Almighty is the last without an end. He is wajibul wujud. His sifat exist. When there was nothing, there was Allah. When there was nothing, there was no sun, no moon, no stars, no planets, no mountains, no rivers, no nothing. No leaves, no air, no water. Nothing existed. But Allah Almighty at that time was. Allah Almighty existed. Hence why His existence is wajibul wujud. His existence is the necessary. Everything masiw Allah, everything other than Allah Almighty is mumkinul wujud. There's imkan, it will exist, it won't exist. And this ayah of the Quran reminds us about this. Allah Almighty is reminding man, was there not a time upon man when he was nothing to even shay'an madhkura? Shay' madhkur means what? He was nothing to even be mentioned. There was no dhikr of insan. And when Allah Almighty wanted to be known, when Allah Almighty wanted to have His ma'rifah to be done, gnosis, and as mentioned in Al-Hadith Al-Qudsi, that كنت كنزا مخفيا. I was a hidden treasure. فبي عرفوني. I wanted to be known. I wanted my معرفة to be done. فقد خلقت خلقا. I created مخلوق. I created إنسان. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. I did not create jinn and I did not create man. What is the purpose of our existence? I did not create jinn or man illa liya'budun, except that they worship me. And here liya'budun, ulama write, the ma'na of liya'buduni is what? Liya'rifuni. I created jinnat and I created insan, man, so that they may recognize me. Liya'rifuni, they have my ma'rifa. What does ma'rifa mean when you have irfan of Allah Jalla wa Ala? Ma'rifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gnosis, to know. And it's sufficient enough for us that we look around the world and we look at the way the world is running, the way the systems are placed within the world, whether it's the weather, whether it's anything related to nature, and we see how the sun, the moon, the stars, how the earth rotates, how the rivers flow. The rivers flow without any force from a generator. How the wind comes about, how the sun shines, how if we was 1 meter closer to the sun, or we was 1 meter, 1 millimeter further away from the sun, we would freeze. What would happen? Today, the world, all the world leaders are worried about global warming, the rise in the earth's temperature, that if it gets to a certain point, and we have to ask ourselves, what is causing global warming? And reality is, it's the fuel emissions, it's the rubbish, and it's caused by man. Yet the earth was in order. Allah Almighty said that we have placed order on this earth. If you disrupt the order of the earth, you will find problems. And have we not seen in the last couple of years, especially in the last decade, the number of, the amount of natural disasters and how the natural triptonic plates under the earth causing earthquakes, causing tsunamis, volcano eruptions, all of this has come about how huge storms, be that in South America, North America, even in Europe. Only I think 6 months ago we had immense amount of storms in Germany, in Europe, which was unknown, unheard of once upon a time. But why? How? This has come about because of what has been caused by man. If we do not take care of earth, we don't look after God's earth, what Allah has created, then there will be disruption, there will be chaos, and there will be discord. And now the world leaders want to implement, by I think 2030, if I'm not mistaken, all cars will move to electric. There won't be no petrol or no diesel cars. They want to eventually get rid of them. They want to take them off the roads, for they feel how, and just look at what COVID teaches us. During this year in COVID, how much has changed? How much has changed during this year in COVID alone? That during this year, when there were no cars on the road being used, they were parked up, how cleaner was the air? There was no pollution within the air. There was no noise pollution. And it tells you that if we take care of this earth, it will remain preserved until Allah Almighty wills for it to be destroyed. And this is why it's important for us to understand that there was nothing in existence, and Allah Almighty existed. And when Allah Almighty existed, He created this earth and He sent mankind. Hafiz ibn Kathir, Rahmatullah alayh, the great historian, the great scholar of Islam, Hafiz ibn Kathir, in his kitab, in his book, Al-Bidayah wal-Nihaya, he wrote a book on the history of, from the time of Sayyidina Adam all the way till his time in the 6th, 7th century. He writes inside there that what's the age of man? Question, how old is man? When was Sayyidina Adam sent onto this earth? It is said, Hafiz ibn Kathir mentions, and Ibn Khaldun and others have also, through their research, have mentioned that the age of man is no more than 10,000 years old. We've existed as humans, men on this earth, for no more than 10,000 years. When Allah Almighty created Sayyidina Adam, earth already existed. The sun, the moon, the stars, everything existed. There was possibly life on earth before our appearance onto this earth. Of course there was, jinnat existed. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah Almighty talks about this. Allah Jalla wa Ala mentions that, إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. I'm going to place my deputy on earth. And the angel said, why? Why are you going to place this new human race, this new being that you've created on earth? That there's already corruption on earth. There's already facade. There's already blood being spilled on earth. There's already wrong happening on earth. Who was causing this facade on earth? Who was spreading corruption on earth before human turned up? Jinnat. The jinns lived on this earth. Sayyidina Adam is like towards the end of creation. He is the last that Allah Almighty has created in terms of human beings, in terms of creation of a being. Jinns existed before, angels existed before jinns. The earth, the sun, the moon, the stars, everything, Sayyidina Adam came at the end. And how long has Sayyidina Adam and his progeny, the children of Sayyidina Adam, lived on earth? 10,000 years. We are in the year 2021 at the moment. This is 2021 years after Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was lifted to the heavens. The Islamic calendar wise, we are in the year 1444 Hijri. This is 1,444 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated from Makkah Mukarramah to Medina Munawwara. Yani the Islamic civilization, Muslims, have only been around how many years? Over 1,400 years. Christianity has existed for over 2,000 years. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam existed 1,000, 2,000 years before that. Sayyidina Ibrahim was around 4,000 years before the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Yani within the space of 6,000 years, 6 to 8,000 years, Allah Almighty sent, come or pesh, give or take, 124,000 Anbiya wa Rusul. Allah Almighty sent 124,000, give or take, prophets on this earth. And they were sent to different tribes, different people throughout mankind, throughout history. We've seen the Greek live and rule. We've seen the Roman Empire, Persian Empire. We've seen the Egyptians live on this earth. They've all had civilizations. They all lived and ruled. We've seen the Babylonians. We've seen so much history. 10,000 years, insan, Allah Almighty reminds us. He said what? هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. How old are you? You're only 10,000 years old. Jinns have lived longer on this earth. Animals have lived longer on this earth. What is your haythiyat? What is your being? Allah Almighty said, خُلِكَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. That man was created weak. خُلِكَ الْإِنسَانُ هُلُوعًا. Man was created in haste. Allah Almighty mentions many a time in the Quran, it is mentioned that over around 66 times the word insan has been used inside the Quran. Ya ayyuhal insanu ma gharraka bi rabbika al-kareem. O man, what has deceived you from your generous Lord? What has distracted you from Allah Jalla wa Ala? Allah Almighty reminds man, walakad khalaqna al-insana min sulalatin min salsalin min hama'in masnoon. خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانَ مِن نُطْفَةٍ. Allah Almighty mentions straight after the verse, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the next verse, إِنَّا خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِن نُطْفَةٍ. We've created you from a drop of sperm. What is insan? Sayyidina Hassan al-Basri rahmatullah alayh, the great Gnostic Arif Billah from the time of the Tabi'een. Hassan al-Basri rahmatullah alayh, he mentions, he said what? He said, this man walks arrogantly on earth, yet he came out from that area of the body where impurity, filth comes out of. Yet what is insan? We are all a product of that drop of semen. One drop of water. And then from there inside the mother's womb is man developed into a fetus, into, you know, a clot, into a fetus, into a baby. And then the mother gives birth. What is, every one of us has been through this process. And then money comes along, a bit of respect comes along, a bit of fame comes along, a bit of dunya comes along, and we think, look at me. Insan then all of a sudden assumes that it's me, I'm the man. There's no one better than me. Look at me, look at the amount of money I have, look at the cars I drive, look at the garments I wear, the clothes I wear. Look at the lifestyle I live. I'm jet setting. Sometimes I'm in Dubai. Sometimes I'm in Morocco. Sometimes I'm in Maldives. You know, man thinks I've got Gucci or I've got Louis Vuitton. And it, you know, look at me. These branded labels made in, man has made these labels. And because we adorn ourselves with this, because it's £1,000 or £2,000 or £2,500 trainers, and we assume, look at my status, look at me. Yet you are a product of a drop of semen. What is insan? That when you will die, you will be buried 6 foot under. Who are we? This is why Allah Almighty said that He does not, anyone who has, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, anyone who has even an atom's worth of arrogance, atom's worth of arrogance in his heart, he will not enter into paradise. He will not enter paradise. Even an atom's worth of arrogance. And a person who has an atom's worth of iman will not enter into the fire of Jahannam. This is why Allah Almighty said, Al-Kibriya'u Kibriya'i. That pride, this is my cloak. Only I have the right to be proud. What is insan? What is insan's nature? Who is insan? Allah Almighty many a time in the Quran has warned us. Many a time in the Quran has told us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us all tawfiq to humble ourselves, to be people of humility, of ajzi and inkisari. Allah Almighty loves the one who is humble. May man tawada'a lillahi rafa'ahu Allah. That he who humbles himself in the court of Allah Almighty will elevate him and raise his maqam. May Allah make us from those people. وأقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم وآخر دعوايا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
لا إله إلا الله 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 لا إله إلا الله جود علينا الله لا إله إلا الله جود علينا.